There seems to be nothing wrong with the clip we just watched, but let's compare it to the one where I fixed the skin tones, and then you'll see a big difference. The skin tones of the first clip go more towards the yellow-greenish side, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how you can fix this problem and how you can get the perfect skin tones every time. We are in Premiere Pro now, and the first thing that we're going to do is we go up to the Lumetri color panel and go to curves. There you have the U versus saturation, the U versus U, and the U versus Luma sliders. And we're going to select the U versus U. We set two dots on the line and the skin tone, so the red orange needs to be in the middle. And you see that as soon as I drag it up and down, the colors change. If you hold shift and you drag up and down, the point stays on the vertical line. Now, if I hold command and I click, I can remove the points. So the first thing that I'll do is I'm going to isolate the skin tones. I'm going to draw a mask on his face, his cheeks, and a bit of his neck to isolate the skin tones, and then I go up to the Lumetri scopes. As you can see, the white line is more towards the yellow-greenish side, and we want the line to be exactly on this line. And that's when you know that the skin tones are correct. We go up to the U versus U slider, we set some points, and then we're going to play around with the settings until the white line is on the line I just mentioned. Something like this. You can play around with it a bit. Then we go up to the U versus saturation, and here we can control the saturation. I think I want to pull the saturation a bit more down, and I think this looks good. Let's see if I toggle it on and off. Yeah, that looks good. Let's toggle off the opacity and see how it looks. Now you can see that all the changes we have done for the skin tones have also applied for the rest of the clip, but we only want to change the skin tones. So what we have to do is we have to select the pen tool at the Lumetri color effect, and we have to draw a mask around the skin tones. I'll speed this up for the sake of this tutorial. Now that I'm done with the mask, I'm going to feather it out a bit. And as you can see, now the only color that changes is the skin tones. I'm going to push a bit more color, a bit more saturation into the skin tones. And that's it, we're done. We corrected the skin tones. Now you know how to fix skin tones and how to get them perfect each and every time. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next.